Hello everyone, today we will discuss the most important topic of our sociology, and the name of the topic is Sociological Theory of Social Changes. It is a very important topic and UPSC will ask this topic each and every year in different format. And we are taking those topics which were asked by UPSC each and every year. So, Sociological Theory of Religion, Sociological Theory of Social Change is a very important topic, and in this lecture we will discuss what are the theories that is related to social change. So as we all know that, how do we start? What should be the introduction part? What should be the body part? And what should be the conclusion part? Now in introduction. So, listen it carefully. In sociological theory of social change, we will start with introduction. And introduction itself, we will define what do you mean by social change. So we can't define anything in a simple manner. We have to take the reference of a particular thinker, and then we will define what do you mean by social change. So definition of social change, according to MacIver, change in the social relationship, change in the social relationship is known as social change. MacIver. Okay, change in the social relationship is known as social change according to MacIver. That should be the definition of social change. Now, the second important topic, what are the steps that leads to social change, which brings social changes? So, we will discuss here also the steps. Steps. There are five steps, or there are five evolutionary linear steps which bring social changes, or that led to the development of social changes in the society. Now, what are the five steps? That is very important, five steps. The first step is growth. The second is evolution. Growth, evolution. The third is development. Listen, these are the five steps. The first is growth. In any society, first growth takes place, then evolution takes place, and then which results into the development. And after development, some progress, which is always positive in nature. Progress also takes place, and at last, if they are incoherent with the society, which leads to revolution in the society. All these five steps bring social changes in the society. Yahan dekh sakte ho. Social change. So your introduction is over. Definition of MacIver, and then what are the steps related to social change. Now the most important point of our topic, that is the body, sociological theory of social change. In sociological theory of social change, we will discuss three theories. The first is linear or functional or evolutionary theory of social change. The second is conflict theory of social change, and the third is the most important theory, that is the cyclic theory of social change. So in this lecture we will discuss only two theories. The first is functionalist or linear theory of social change. The second is conflict theory of social change. In the next video we will discuss cyclic theory of social change. Now listen it carefully. Linear theory or the functional theory or the evolutionary theory of social change said that society moves from one stage to another stage and never come back to the previous stage. Society moves from one stage to another stage, and which leads to development in the society, and the movement brings social changes in the society. This is all about the linear theory of social change, and in this linear theory of social change we will discuss the most important thinker, that is Parson. He said society moves from one stage to another stage, and he gave four stages of the society. In this society moves in a linear fashion, ekdam linear. So what are that stages, I will discuss here. The first, ancient. linear theory, Parson. So he said that, he said in linear theory of social change, Parson said that society moves from one stage to another stage and never come back. This is all about linear theory of social change, and that social change is functional in nature. So in this, he said that society moves from primitive stage to the ancient stage, and then move to the intermediate stage, and then to the modern industrial society. See, in primitive stage, men are like hunter and gatherers. People are developing their capabilities to adapt to the nature. People are fighting for their survival. So this is all about the characteristic features of the primitive stage. Now, what is in the ancient society? In ancient society, agriculture developed. Settled life begins. People start living together. This is all about the characteristic features of the ancient society. So from primitive society, ancient society came. Tribal, and then we move on to the ancient society. Then from the ancient society, intermediate society come. This is a transitory in nature. And what are the characteristics of the intermediate society? System of kinship developed. Kinship means sociological expression of the biological relationship is known as kinship. So here kinship, culture and language. Kinship, culture and language develops. In the modern industrial society, that is the last stage of any society, from primitive to the modern industrial society. This is ancient, this is primitive, intermediate, and in the last modern industrial society, in which human beings are capable to change the nature with the help of technology. In this, democracy come. Liberal democracy came into existence. Individualism exists. So this is all about the characteristics, features of the modern industrial society, in which with the help of technology, human beings are capable to influence the nature. And here in the primitive society, human beings are just adapting to the nature. So this is all about the evolutionary theory or the linear theory of social change. Society moves from this stage to this stage. And at last, what Parson say? We will write in the conclusion of Parson. We will write conflict theory of social change, then in conclusion, and here it's a linear theory of social change, then in linear theory of social change, we will write in conclusion the Parson concept. He said that society is never static. Society is never static. It is always changing and try to maintain its equilibrium. So, and that is the reason he gave the concept of moving equilibrium. Moving equilibrium concept. Because society changes itself according to the needs of the individuals. According to the needs of the individual, society changes itself without changing the existing social order of the society. So he gave the concept of moving equilibrium. Society moves from one stage to another stage. Now, we will write some criticism. Criticism. So, what are the criticism of this? What are the criticism of this theory, linear theory of social change? In this, he never mentioned the social changes which are caused by the external factors. The social changes which are caused by the external factors like wars, social movements, that are the things also bring social changes in the society. Na? He never talk about that war. Social movements. First, and what should be the second most important criticism of Parson theory of linear change, social theory of linear change? He said that his theory is not applicable to seedbed societies. His theory is not applicable to seedbed societies. So, what are seedbed societies? Seedbed societies are like Israel. they have no primitive history. They are not in the stage of primitive ancient stage or intermediate stage. They are developed in 1949, I think it's so. 1949, and they are directly modern industrial society. So this theory is not applicable to seedbed societies, Israel. So the concept is over, introduction, definition of social change, what are the states of social change, and then linear theory of social change and some criticism. Now, conclusion, we will write the concept of moving equilibrium. Now, what is the conflict theory of social change? As linear theory said, society moves from one place to another place, one stage to another, and never come back to its previous stage. Conflict theory is just opposite to linear theory of social change. Because conflict theory is all about what? Conflict theory, linear theory is all about functionalist in nature. Society is functional in nature. Conflict theory says that it is the conflict in the society which brings social changes. So in this we will discuss three thinkers. Conflict theory of social change, we will discuss three thinkers, the most important thinker. The first is Marx, the second is Oppenheimer, and the third is Ralph Dahrendorf. So conflict theory, Marx. What he said? He said that it is the unequal distribution of wealth in the society. This theory is known as economic deterministic theory. He said that it is the unequal distribution of wealth in the society which creates conflict between the haves and the have-nots. That brings social changes in the society. And he talks about five stages or the five types of societies. The first is primitive. The second is ancient society, the third is feudal society, the fourth is capitalist society, and the fifth is communism. Master, slave, lord, serfs, petty bourgeois, and proletariat. So he said that in the ancient period, in feudal society, in ancient society, and in the capitalist society, there is unequal distribution of wealth. And due to unequal distribution of wealth, the conflict arises between two groups. The first group, which are the haves groups, and the second is the have-nots group. Master and slave, lord and serf, and petty bourgeois and proletariat. So these are the two groups in which conflict arises. And once the conflict arises between these two groups, which brings social changes in the society. So this theory is just opposite to functionalist or linear theory of social change. That conflict is the main reason to bring social changes in the society. In this we will also discuss the concept of Ralph Dahrendorf. He said that it is the unequal distribution of authority which leads to conflict in the society, which brings social changes in the society. Unequal distribution of authority. Some people are holding the authority and they are minority. They are in minority, and those people who are in majority, they never hold the authority. So there is conflict between two peoples, one holding the authority and the another which is not holding the authority. That results into the conflict in the society and brings social changes in the society. And the third thing that we will discuss, Oppenheimer. He said that it is a general principle that superior rules the inferior. So with the passage of time, there is development of consciousness in the inferior quality of the people, and they just organize themselves and create a revolt against the superior people, and that brings social changes in the society. So this theory is just opposite to the linear theory. So in this lecture we will discuss the linear theory or revolutionary or functional theory of social change by Parson, and then conflict theory of social change by Marx, Ralph Dahrendorf, and Oppenheimer, and then conclusion. In conclusion we will write, it depends upon the time and space that which type of things leads to social changes in society.
So this is all about sociological theory of religion, and in the next lecture we will discuss the cyclic theory of social change, which is a very important concept, and UPSC will ask this topic in 20 marker. They said you simply discuss any two theories of religion. And if they ask you in 10 marker question, they will personally ask you, they ask you, what do you mean by linear theory of social change, and what do you mean by conflict theory of social change, or what do you mean by cyclic theory of social change. So this is all about the lecture, and hope you like the lecture. Thank you.